everyone. I'm Liao Qing from Anyuan, Pingxiang. Nice to see you again. Today, let's go on in Unit 2. I will help to clean up the city parks. Section B, 3A, 3B. In this class, we will review the knowledge about volunteering. And by the end of this class, I believe we will be able to write a letter or email to the place we want to volunteer at. Now first, let's review the story about Ben Smith. He writes a letter to Miss Lee, right? And do you still remember why? Okay, let's try to fill in the blanks with the proper words. Okay, I'll give you 2 minutes. Okay, let's do it together. Ben Smith is a disabled man. He has many difficulties in his life. He can't use his arms or legs well. Some normal things like answering the telephone, opening and closing the doors, or carrying things are difficult for him. But lucky, the dog helper makes a difference to his life. Lucky is a fantastic dog. It's very clever and understands many English words. It can understand him when he gives him order. So, why does Ben write a thank you letter to Miss Lee? Yes, because Miss Lee gives money to animal helpers to help disabled people, and thus makes it possible for Ben to have lucky. This is a kind of volunteer work, right? Now, please look at these kinds of volunteer work. Working in an old people's home, helping kids in an after-school program, being a guide at a museum, 在博物馆当导游, Can you add more? In this unit, we talked about many kinds of volunteer work, right? Now, you have 1 minute to write as many as possible. 写尽可能的多。 Okay, let's begin. Okay, how many kinds of volunteer work did you write? Now, let me show you some. Let's watch a video. Okay, these are what we are talking about in this unit. We can do a lot of volunteer work, and we can use these sentence structures to offer help. Now, volunteering and charity are everywhere. So, what kind of volunteer work do you want to do? Think it over. Now, let's play a guessing game. Let's guess what they would like to do. Now, first, look at the girl. She is good at drawing, and she is good with kids. In her free time, he likes playing with kids. So, can you guess what kind of volunteer work would she like to do? Yes, I'd like to visit sick kids and cheer them up. Okay, what about the boy? He is strong in telling stories. That means he is good at telling stories. Be strong in, be good at, 擅长。他擅长讲故事。And he is good with old people. In his free time, he likes reading newspapers. So, what kind of volunteer work would he like to do? Have a guess.That's right. I'd like to volunteer in an old people's home. So we can see that we can help others with our interests and hobbies. Interest, 兴趣, interest, 可以用我们的兴趣和爱好来帮助其他人。So, how to help others with your interests and hobbies?Now, for example, my name is Rita. My interest is studying. So the volunteer work I want to do is teaching kids. So I would like to say, I'm strong in studying. So I'd like to teach kids. Now, can you fill in the chat with your information and your friends or your family's information? 用你的信息，你家人或者你朋友的信息来完成表格。And report like this. Can you? Now, have a try. Let's look at the information about Lucy. Let's say it together, okay? Now, Lucy is strong in housework. So, she would like to clean up the city parks. What about Mike? Mike is strong in reading. So, he would like toHelp kids to read. Wow, so many people are willing to do some volunteer work. Now, here's a chance for you. 那你们的机会来了。Now, two teachers put up posters. They want volunteers. 他们需要志愿者。Now, let's read the posters one by one.And choose a kind of volunteer work according to your interests and hobbies. 那根据你的兴趣和爱好来选择一种你想做的志愿活动。Now, let's look at the first poster. Please read it carefully and fill in the blanks with the proper words or phrase. Okay, let's begin. Okay, let's read it together. Good morning, my dear students. I'm Mr. Lee. If everyone can share a little love, the world will be better and better. Spring is coming. We are going to have a special school trip in the city park. You could pick up the rubbish, 捡垃圾, plant trees, sweep the roads to make it more beautiful. Join us and have a great time. Okay, Mr. Lee wants volunteers in the city parks. Now let's look at the second poster. It is from Miss Yang. Now read it carefully and find the answers to the questions. What could we do for the old? And why should we help them? Okay, please read it carefully. Let's check the answers together. Number one, what could we do for the old? First, we could clean up their rooms. Then, we could talk with them and listen to them. And what's more, we can sing and dance to make them happy if we are good at music. We can do a lot of things for the old people. Now pay attention to these link words. First, then, what's more. You can use them in your passage.
在你写作的时候可以恰当地用上这些连词。
Okay, the second question. Why should we help them? Why?Because caring for the old people is our Chinese tradition.
关爱老人是我们中国的传统。
And because sometimes the old people are very lonely. And because everyone will be old one day. So we should care for the old people.Okay, Mr. Lee wants volunteers in the city parks, and Miss Yang, she wants volunteers
at the old people's home. So, according to your interest and hobbies, where do you want to volunteer at?
根据你的兴趣和爱好，你想去哪里做志愿活动呢？
Now, after making your choice, you need to write a letter or email to the place you want to volunteer at.
做好决定之后呢，需要写一封信或者是邮件到你想参加志愿活动的地方去。
Of course, if you don't want to volunteer at the city park or the old people's home, you could write to anywhere you want.
如果你既不想去公园，也不想去敬老院，你可以写到别的地方。
Okay, this is a letter or email. So first, pay attention to the format of a letter.
注意信的格式。
那首先我们要有称呼。Dear Sir or Madam. Sir, 先生。Sir, Madam. Madam, 女士。Dear Sir or Madam. Sir, Madam,
首字母大写了。这种称呼常用于你不知道收信人的姓名和性别的时候。
Now, you can use Dear Sir or Madam. And at the end of the letter, there must be a complimentary clause.
真诚的结束语。
For example, Yours truly, yours sincerely, and etc. AndDon't forget your signature.
不要忘了你的签名。
Okay, this is the format of a letter,
信的格式。
Then, what should we write in the body of the letter?
主体部分我们应该写什么呢？
I think you need to answer these five questions. Now, number one. What volunteer job do you want to do?
那你先要点名你想参加的志愿活动。
You can use these sentences. You can say, I'd like to, I'm interested in, or I want to volunteer as. Number two, what are your interests and hobbies? You can say, I'm good at, I'm strong in, and in your free time, I like to,So I think I'd be good at this job. Now, the third question. How can this help you to do the job? You can say, first, I could. Then, what's more, also. Okay, number four. Why do you want to do the volunteer job? You can say,I want to help out as a volunteer in your old people's home, in your school, in your museum, in your group. Because, not the last question, you should answer when you are free to do the job. You may say, I'm free to help in or on. Okay.Let's summarize how to write this conversation. Now,
第一，注意写书信的格式，称呼、结尾、签名。
Number two, you need to answer the five questions. Now, number three,
运用正确的连词。
For example, first, then, what's more, also.etc.
有好的开头，有好的结尾，好的句子。
Now, number four,
再通读一遍自己的文章，检查一下。检查什么呢？检查是否符合评价标准。你的信的结构
它是符合新的格式吗？有没有三个部分？内容上，它是不是包含了所有的细节？语言上是否有拼写或者是语法错误？有没有恰当的使用连词？有没有好的句子、好的开头、好的结尾？最后，你的书写是否 clean and tidy, 干净整洁？ This is also very important. Now I believe all of you know how to write this composition, right? So, are you ready to start writing? Now, let's begin.
Okay, time limited. You can finish your conversation after class.
那时间有限，希望大家课后可以完成你的作文。
Now, let me show you my composition. Dear sir or madam, I'm writing to you about volunteering. I'd like to volunteer in your old people's home. I'm very kind and friendly. I'm good at singing and dance. In my free time, I like to do some reading and listen to music. So I think I'd be good at this job. First, I could listen to them and talk to them. Then I could read newspapers. What's more, I could sing and dance for them. I want to join you because I know a lot of old people are lonely. They need to be cared and listened to. I'm free to help on weekends. I believe I will be a great volunteer. I hope you can give me this chance. Yours truly, Rita. Okay, let's check the letter together. Now first is the format of the letter.
信的格式有称呼，有结束语，有签名。
Now here are three parts in the body of the letter. The first part is the beginning. What would I like to volunteer to do? The second part, how could I help? And why would I help? And when could I help? And then here are some link words.Now, the last part is the ending, a summary or my opinion. So, I hope you can finish your composition after class. I hope you write it with your sincerity. I hope you truly want to help others and the world will be better and better. Okay.This is today's homework. Now, that's all for today. Goodbye, everyone.